Yo, so before we get into it, if you like that video, press on that like button because that helps your boy a ton. Like, it really helps me. The latest videos I made on the NVIDIA one, the likes were not there. So let's reach around 100 likes. I don't know. Yeah, I'll leave that to you. I'm pretty sure you'd help me out. And subscribe if you found this video helpful or want to see more build guides. I keep on saying there is like a gaming PC coming, but it's like, you know, a mix of, I don't know, failed projects and upcoming projects that I haven't decided which parts to get yet, so I'm sorry for that. Alright peeps, so in this video we're looking at a 1200 bucks Ryzen gaming PC build with the latest brand new RTX 3070. For the CPU, we're looking at the Ryzen 7 3700X. It's an 8 core 16 threaded CPU and it's a good CPU. It's clocked at around 3.5 gigahertz or 3.6. It would do fine at video editing, streaming. When you compare it to a CPU like the 10700K and productivity, it's pretty much the same. So yeah, it's a very good CPU for 290 bucks. The reason I did it went for the Ryzen 5 3600 because it's for $200 and that's very expensive. This CPU like a month ago was for 160 bucks, and as soon as the Ryzen 5 4600 drops, this CPU I believe it should be for around 140 or even 130. Like, yeah, it will go down so hard. But make sure if you got these third gen Ryzen CPUs, once the fourth gen Ryzen CPUs drops, you should get it ASAP because you'd get like an extra 20 or 30% performance uplift. As for the board, we're looking at the MSI B550M Pro VDH board that has 4 RAM slots, up to 128 gigs of DDR4 RAM, and DDR4 up to like a crazy amount of RAM frequency, I believe like 4400 or something like that. And it's got PCIe Gen 4, support for Ryzen 4th gen CPUs. And there's also the Gigabyte B550M Aorus one. I'll leave a link to it on Newegg because the Amazon one is out of stock. So you can pick between both. You cannot go wrong with either. So yeah, a very good option for sub 120 bucks for this PC build. As for the RAM, we're looking at 16 gigs, 2 8GB sticks of DDR4 3600 MHz. RAM for around $62 from G-Skill, but the brand might like vary if this deal went out of stock or the price has changed. This PC is pretty slim, so any double like 6-8 gigabyte sticks that are clocked at around DDR4 3600 megahertz would do, and that would give you the full potential out of gaming. But you gotta make sure you enable the XMP profile on the BIOS. But 16 gigs is more than enough for anything you should be doing nowadays, except for like 8K gaming. But not a lot of people have like dipped their toes in 8K gaming, so that doesn't tell you if 16 gigs is enough or not. But for now, it is pretty good. As for the SSD, we're looking at the M.2 1TB SSD for around 90 to 95 bucks. It's from Crucial, I believe, or maybe WD. But you know, M.2 SSDs like saves you some space. The PC won't be heavy if you want for like an ergonomic SSD, that 2.5 inch one, or like a mechanical hard drive. And 1TB is more than enough space, and you're getting this fast boot up times and loading speeds and like fast everything for around 95 bucks. SSDs became really cheap now, and yeah, this would do. As for the GPU, and you could tell we're looking at the RTX 3070, but I don't think it will be for 500 bucks on launch. It should be for somewhere around 500 to 550 bucks. So I just added something for 550 bucks. If you could find it for 500, that means, you know, you're saving an extra 50 bucks, man. But yeah, for now, I don't think it will be 500 bucks on launch. Can even go over 550. But it's a solid GPU, 8 gigs of VRAM, I believe, 220 watts. So I think it will not need that very stupid dual pin to 12 pin adapter. So yeah, it's pretty good compared to the RTX 2080 Ti. It's faster at times, allegedly. That's what Nvidia claims, and if it's not, it's if it's on par or like 2% slower, the newer updates and the newer games will behave better on this GPU rather than the older versions. So yeah, a really good GPU for 500 bucks. Like, if you told me you could get that GPU that, you know, matches the performance of the RTX 2080 Ti for half the price, like 3 days before the launch, I'd say you're crazy. And yeah, it's crazy what's going on here right now. But as for the case, we're looking at the Cooler Master MB311L RGB case for 60 bucks. It's got mesh panels, really good airflow, as you can see. You can add some extra RGB fans if you want to, but it's not that needed, you know. And it gets the job done for 60 bucks. It's a micro 80X case, so you might keep that in mind. And as for the power supply, we're looking at Corsair's 650 watt 80 plus power supply. Now this PSU might be, you know, changed, or you can also go for an EVGA one if you couldn't find that one in stock. And 650 watt is more than enough for the RTX 3070. So that's been it, guys. If you like that video, press on the like button. If I see more videos of that kind, subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.